the addition. Well, it's the epidemic silently growing among Australians. I'm talking about loneliness.
Hello? Anybody?
There he is, very lonely.
That's lonely.
That is lonely. Not if you have a phone, though, surely. You don't have to be stuck on an island to feel isolated nowadays, and people of all ages and backgrounds are affected.
It's all you needed, a phone, really. And even though modern technology has made it easier for us to connect with each other, statistics show we're feeling more alone than ever before. Well, social analyst Mark McCrindle joins us now to break all this down. Good to see you, Mark.
Yeah, likewise.
Hey, we all like to think that Facebook and Twitter, our accounts and our friends and our likes make us popular, but it's not really the case.
No, that's right. I mean, we've got 1 billion people on Facebook and yet more isolation than ever. For many, even the term social networking is a misnomer because it actually creates an antisocial environment in a lot of ways. People feel a competitiveness when they're online. They sometimes end up being more superficial than real. And tweets are not conversations. You know, it's not real authentic community. So it can provide a facade of community without providing that real engagement.
Are social skills something that we need to work on? You know, use it or lose it?
Yeah, definitely. And a lot of teachers particularly have noticed with this generation of students that they can end up hiding behind the technology, and rather than facilitating social skills, they end up not having those same social skills or people skills as people in the past did. So when you're on technology a lot, you can almost use it to be a social risk reducer, mm-hmm. and you can end up with a smaller comfort zone and not the same confidence in building relationships as we used to have.
It's not just younger generation though, is it? I mean, people don't even go next door to, you know, ask for a cup of sugar, do they?
No, that's right. And this is ironic. I mean, we've got 8 million more people in Australia today than 30 years ago. We're living closer to each other, yeah. in terms of our density than ever before. And yet there are more people sort of isolated and lonely. And that traditional community, you know, where we volunteered or we were part of this club or this organisation, we don't have that as much. We tend to bunker down in a bit more anonymity.
We're seeing some graphics here that in 1983, single-person households made up 16% of the population, now 23% of the population. Mm. And we're actually staying alone for longer. We're getting married later and so on. What can people do if they're feeling lonely, apart from go and bludge cups of sugar from the next door neighbour? Because that's a money-saving device as
well.
That's
right.
Yeah, I think we've got to work harder at it, as you say, because we've pushed back starting a family, we've pushed back getting married. People are going to be single later in life. That's just the reality. And that figure there shows that we 30 years ago had 800,000 solo person households. Now we've got 2 million of them. So I think we have to not just rely on going online. We can use online to find real groups, a running club or a reading club or an organisation with whom we can volunteer. It's using the technology to create real offline relationships, not just doing everything in terms of social needs online.
Makes sense.
Put your phone away. That's what I say.
Yeah.
Mark,
right.
Good to see you. Thanks,
okay,
mate.
Okay, thank you.